Mount Pleasant.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. Sometimes I feel like it's the last comic standing in this house. Vancouver's housing market is so out of control, it's now the subject of a reality TV show. People who call the city home don't want a housing crisis fueled by foreign speculation. People shouldn't have to feel like their lives are the subject of a reality TV show. So my question is for the Minister of Finance. Don't you think it's time to stop denying the role of foreign speculation in our housing market?
Yeah. Minister of Finance.
Madam Speaker, and doesn't the member think it's time to base public policy of this import on actual data and facts? Because, Madam Speaker, I have never attempted to I've never attempted to convey this in an accusatorial way. But it was actually during the 1990s that basic questions about people's citizenship were deleted from the forms that have to be signed when people purchase real estate. Now, the member purports and her colleagues purport to stand here and offer up these theories. These are the same members who said just a month or two ago that the cause of the distress in Vancouver was vacancy. They said that. And they were advocating for a vacancy tax until the facts revealed, Madam Speaker, that the vacancy rate today is lower than it was 12 years ago.
Thank you.
So, Madam Speaker, I'm sorry I'm destined to disappoint the member, because on this side of the House, the government will base decisions on the most important asset that British Columbia families will ever own on facts and not theory and conjecture and what is politically expedient for members of the opposition.
Recognizing Vancouver Mount Pleasant on a supplemental.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. I'd love to see that minister collect some data on the housing crisis here in British Columbia. Back to SFU. The study from SFU is clear. When
Members.
It comes to Vancouver's housing crisis, quote, we have mostly a demand problem, not a supply problem, and it's foreign demand, end quote. So what happens when you have a government asleep at the wheel and foreign investment being poured into the housing
Members.
Market? Well, oh.
Members.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Honourable Speaker. I'll repeat. So what happens when you have a government asleep at the wheel and foreign investment being poured into the housing market? Well, as the study tells us, we see millennials getting pushed out of the housing market, rising debt levels, ghost neighbourhoods where houses and condos are sitting empty. We also see unscrupulous real estate activity, money laundering, and tax inequity. These are the things people in Vancouver are seeing every day, and it's unacceptable. Honourable Speaker, the fact is, reality bites when it comes to housing affordability in Vancouver. So to the Minister, what will it take for this government to address the housing crisis?
Minister of Finance.
Well, Madam Speaker, to the member,
Members.
I should say to the member who I think asked these questions in good faith that I disagree fundamentally with her premise when she says this is a demand issue and not a supply issue. You know, Madam Speaker, I make this confession, I think it's a good thing that people are coming to British Columbia in record numbers from other parts of Canada. I actually think it's
Members. Members.
I actually think, Madam Speaker, it's a good thing that when people cast their eye around the world and think about where they want to raise a family, that they decide British Columbia is that place, and they come here and they generate enterprise and they create jobs and they make investment. I think that's a good thing. I also think this, Madam Speaker, that in a market where there is a finite supply of land bordered by mountains, ocean, and international border, we have some difficult decisions to make. There is a finite supply of single detached homes. That is not going to change. The demand for those homes, based on where we live, what we are blessed with naturally, and the country's leading economy, is only going to increase. So we have some decisions to make about density, about land use, and British Columbians will be better served if all governments work together to make those decisions on behalf of citizens. Sure.